Hey everyone, this is Dark Soul 100. Today, we're going to be playing a real-time strategy game. Little Pikmin! Just to let you know, I have never completed a Pikmin game. Not even Pikmin 2, which you aren't timed on, pretty much. You can take a thought. This game. I just can't. Couldn't plan as good as others in this. I'm gonna try it though. Let's start the game. I didn't know I had a file already on this, but okay. That music was cool. The impact site. Still don't know if this is loud enough for you guys. Where am I? What's going on here? Huh? What is that? It's my rocket! What happened to it? My name is Captain Olimar. While traveling through space, my ship was struck by a meteor. I must have blacked out, and I woke on the surface of a weird planet. With so many parts lost, the skeletal hull of my beloved dolphin is a painful sight. The engine is gone. I'm stranded. To make matters worse, my atmospheric sensors indicate this planet's environment contains high levels of poisonous oxygen. My life support systems can function for only 30 days. If I can't repair the dolphin by then? No, better not to think about it. I must find the missing ship parts. Whee! Bam! Bam! Damn! Damn! Damn it! Whoa, where's that pointing me? Oh, well, hello. Okay. I don't know how the controls work, so I'll be studying them. Let me in! Oh, hello. A strange thing has appeared before me. I had barely begun my search when it reared up as if it were waiting for me. It then dropped a single seed. What is it? Is it alive? Is it a machine? It resembles a vegetable on my home planet that we call an onion. I shall call this an onion too. That seed that the onion dropped took root in the soil and has now produced an adorable little sprout. This sprout emits a strange light and it sways back and forth without benefit of wind. I cannot help but think it is calling to me. I am compelled. I must approach it and press A. Yes, I must. This is not weird in any way, shape, or form. Need to make sure I can actually move my remote. Dang it. Extraordinary! When I plucked the sprout, it turned out to be a living creature, not a plant. Picking it has done no visible damage. It just stands there, staring at me and scratching its head. Its shape is similar to the Pick-Pick brand carrots I love so much. I believe I shall call it a Pikmin. Here I am, stranded on a toxic planet, fighting to survive, and yet I'm intrigued. I must research this fascinating creature. I shall try to grab it with A and then throw it in the direction I point. And I will call it to my side with B. Perhaps it will react to C and sink down the control pad while pointing it as well. The following controls appear to allow me view several viewpoints. Rotate camera behind Olimar. Left and right. Zoom. Up. Change perspective. I must survive. I need to familiarize myself with these controls and my surroundings. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. I also need. What does this Pikmin think of me? I must observe its reactions. The more things I try, the more reactions I can catalog. Oh, shut up! I already heard this! Astonishing! The onion has sown more seeds. The small red pellet the Pikmin harvested after cutting down a flower appears to be some type of food that can propagate more Pikmin. The onion seems to be a sort of incubator. Needless to say, I must study this strange life form more. Let's try this again. Okay. Let's go this way. Pick him up! Don't throw them! My incapability to get used to these controls is the thing that's gonna cause me the most trouble here. Nope, wrong control. Four, they're like, we're right here. Can we do anything for ya? Well, they're like, push, 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 push. The Piklin are as curious as children. They form groups of formed tasks that would be impossible for an individual. A glimmer of hope has begun to shine in my heart. If I can make use of their skills, perhaps I can fix my ship. I shall sum up all I've learned of Pikmin conduct. I don't care about all that. It's just a repeat of the controls. Hello over there. Can't do anything over there though. Well, when many Pikmin seeds sprout at once, I find it rather tedious to flush them from the ground individually. My wife always told me I was no good at routine tasks. I guess I'll try to get it all done at once by repeatedly tapping it until I pick all the Pikmin from the ground. I've noticed that when I add Pikmin to my group, they become filled with excitement and flushed with bright color. At other times, they revert to a paler hue and give off a dim glow. Tangle's attention to these differences is bound to help me distinguish between Pikmin. That's spot 25. Any more? Okay, where is he? What are you doing over here? Amazing! There's no mistaking it. My ship's engine rests before my very eyes. By a stroke of pure luck, I already stumbled upon the most important piece of my damaged craft. They had smiled upon me. But how will I get it back to the dolphin? How else? I'm resisting the urge to call that one Pikmin Steve. Because that's Sugar Conroy's joke. I look so weird with my big nose. I look much different as a character model than I do in my little life gauge. area. Do you guys notice that? Look at him dance! One of them was stretching his head up! Stop stretching your head up, guys! You're creeping me out! Wait, where are you guys going? Oh, glorious. With the help of these Pikmin, I take a huge step back toward home. My ship can once again lift off. The glimmer of hope is beginning to burn more brightly. What has become of the remaining parts? That search starts tomorrow. One day since impact, I have somehow managed to launch the dolphin, but I was surprised to see the onion lift off with me. Perhaps the pygmy cannot survive overnight on the planet's surface, or have they merely decided to join me for other reasons? Either way, it seems they will hunt me again tomorrow. The dolphin is missing 29 parts. If I can't recover them all, I may never return home to my family on planet Hawkcake. Analysis shows light support systems will function for only 29 more days. How can I repair my dolphin in such a short time? A dense forest that's visible on the surface below. As it holds the keys to my survival, I'll name it the Forest of Hope. I'll explore it tomorrow. Alright, we shall continue this next time. Thank you guys for watching this episode. I'll see you then.